Can you make money playing games online? There's actually a whole lot of videos on YouTube claiming you can. So in this video, I'm gonna spend 8 hours straight trying to play online games that apparently pay you real life money to play them in order to figure out if this kind of thing can actually be a legitimate way to earn a living or at least make some coffee money or make any money at all. I might sound a little crazy if you're not familiar with this concept, but this is a real thing. If you search up make money playing games online on YouTube, people make some wild claims talking about you can make $500 per day, $36 an hour, $75 per day, a hundo. I mean, that's crazy. $500 a day? That's like almost 200 grand a year. Why would you spend 10 years going to college, accumulate student debt, and then work a stressful job as a surgeon when you can make the same amount playing games according to this video? Man! No, but I've actually even gotten a few comments about a new genre of these online paid games that's been emerging in the crypto NFT space, and apparently that's a very legitimate thing. But for this next type of game, I'm actually really excited about, and we are gonna start the 8-hour journey with them. These are skill-based games in which you compete for real money against other people. Is it gambling? It's a fine line, but I don't think it's defined as that because these aren't roulette or slots type games. They're regular mobile games, so it's kind of similar to sports, right? You can be competing in a paid tennis tournament. Is that gambling? Maybe I'm just trying to justify poor financial decisions here. I don't know.
But these are not investment strategies.
That's correct.
It's actually kind of interesting the way I stumbled on this whole concept. I searched up compete in games for money on Google, which led me to this Cash for Skills website on which there's a big list of games you can download on your phone and compete for real money on, which sounded really sketchy to me. It almost sounds illegal. Does the Apple App Store really allow this kind of thing? I didn't know, but I downloaded a couple of the games on the website. Some didn't even load up, but a few did, and the ones that did were powered by something called Skills, which I started searching up to see if that's a scam or not, and found that it's a platform that integrates into iOS and Android games and allows players to compete against each other for money. So I put $10 on my Skills account, then played a dollar match, ended up actually winning my first game, although you only end up with 40 cents. It's a 60 cent entry fee, both players pay it, one keeps a dollar, so the odds aren't the best. The Skills company is the one that really wins every game. In fact, turns out this business model is so good that ARK Invest, a very respected cutting edge ETF, actually holds $200 billion worth of shares of the Skills company. I'm a fan and hold ARK ETF, so technically I'm even invested in this Skills company. So that's what made me kind of trust them. I still don't know if I'll be able to withdraw the money, but given that there's actually a publicly traded company behind all of it and ARK is investing into this company, that really built up my confidence. I'm thinking we deposit $100 into the Skills network of games, download a bunch of them, and see where we're at in 2 hours. Which games are the best? Will I lose all of the money, or will I make millions? Hour zero, current balance is $100 and the 40 cents that I won from the game that I played yesterday. We're gonna go ahead and start with this words game. I'm gonna play it for a bit and then we'll try some other ones. 2 minutes on the clock. Let's get it. First word, God. I feel it. This is gonna be a blessed game. GED, Todd, dot, dots, dub, sub to the channel, doge. They counted that one. So I ended up playing the words game for a while. I would lose some rounds, win others, kind of playing at a break-even level, but leaning more towards the losing side. Pretty early on though, I stopped getting matched with live players and would just have to submit my scores, and the app said they would match me with someone when they became available, which was a little suspicious. After the word game though, I tried out this racing game, which was pretty fun, but I tried playing a paid round. I had to submit my score, and then I guess no one plays this game since I never ended up getting matched, so that round is still open, and I didn't play anymore since I couldn't actually compete if there's nobody playing. Given that this was the case, I ended up going on the Skills website and finding the popular section for their games. This way, I knew there would be other people playing them, which this led me to find a pool game that I ended up playing for a while. Pretty fun, lots of people on there. But at the end of the 2 hours, our total balance was $93, so we did lose $7 in the 2 hours. So we were working for negative $3.50 per hour, which is below minimum wage for most regions in the US. Okay, we are now 2 hours in. Not gonna lie, all the glitches and whatnot aside, these games are a pretty good time. Having money on the line makes things very interesting, but I think there has to be some sneaky business going on the back end of these skills games. Because if you think about it, their whole goal is to keep you playing, since they take a cut of every match, so the more matches you play, the more money they make. Meaning, they don't want you losing all of your money right away, they want you to win some, lose some, and kind of keep your balance at a similar level while slowly going down in order to lure you in and keep you hooked and keep you playing more matches. I don't know. There definitely has to be an algorithm behind this, although I don't know how advanced or malicious or profit hungry it is. I would keep playing these, but I want to give some of these other games a chance. Maybe we'll come back to it. But next up is Access Infinity, which a lot of you guys have been commenting that I should try. I don't know much about it, but it's a game that has to do with crypto and NFTs. There seems to be a huge community around it, so I'm going to watch some videos about it and try to figure out what it even is, see if we can make some money with it, and I'll report back in like an hour or two. So this whole game is centered around these little monsters called axes, which are NFTs with different levels of rarity and utility in the game. But you basically just build up a team of them, and then you can battle other people's teams. For doing so, I believe you earn a crypto called SLP, which is used for Access Infinity's internal economy. However, you can exchange that to whatever crypto or currency you want once you have it. But I think the real money isn't in the battles, but rather in breeding the monsters. Once you have two of them, you can pay a fee to breed them and then sell your offspring on the market, which is the cheapest axes right now are going for like 400 bucks. It's really expensive to get into this game at the moment. You can also rent out your axes to other players. There's a whole program for that. There's also the ability to buy land. I mean, it gets pretty deep. I haven't mastered all of the complexities of this entire game, but you really can make money with this. There's people on YouTube right now making like 100 grand a month with it. End of the day though, it's not all sunshine and rainbows. This is pretty risky. If the crypto market crashes, if people stop playing the game, there's a lot of factors here that can make your investment into the game just completely disappear. I did try out though. To do so, I had to buy three axes. Each one was worth around $450. I got absolutely taxed, but I bought them. I played some battles, kind of did some digging. It was pretty cool. I can see how this is succeeding, and there's opportunity there to build a whole business inside of this game that will pay you real money, which is crazy. We didn't end up making money with Axie Infinity, but you can expect to on your first day with this game, because it's kind of like an investment or starting a business depending on which route you take with your gameplay. But wow, I can see how if you research this game really well and run all of your numbers properly, you definitely could make some serious money with not so much the battling, but through the breeding and renting out of the little axes. Which, I mean, look at them. They are pretty cute, but I can't believe I just spent like 1500 bucks on them. They do look cool and are NFTs. I could sell them, so who knows? Maybe they're gonna be worth even more in the future as this game grows more popular, or maybe they'll be worth nothing if the game dies down. Anyways, as you can see, it's now 3 o'clock. Next up, we're gonna try to play online poker for these final 2 hours. Controversial choice, because poker is essentially gambling. I wouldn't recommend it to anyone, but there are professional poker players, right? So there are players of this card game who got really good at it and are able to consistently win. A lot of it is just random luck, but there is this aspect to the game of analyzing probability, reading people, and knowing how to play your cards right. Most people are gambling when they play poker. They don't stick to a strategy, don't pay attention, just kind of wing it. They're at a casino, they're slightly faded, but I want to see what happens if we watch some YouTube videos on some strategies and try to implement that. Can we stay profitable over the next couple hours playing for real money and treating it like a sport? I'm gonna start with $100 here and let's see where things go. So I try to use a tight and very safe poker strategy. I folded a lot of hands right off the bat if they weren't good. I didn't do a lot of bluffing, which led to me just slowly losing some money. However, I eventually got a full house, which is the fourth highest hand. I played it fairly well, lured someone in, they matched my bets, and I won, so that gave me some hope. But I ended up taking a huge loss to someone with a lot of money on the table. Mans was just bullying everyone the whole time. I thought he was bluffing, so I matched his bets on one of the rounds and ended up taking a huge L. And it was all downhill from there. Eventually, I got caught up, went all in, lost it all, and the $100 was gone.
It's gone. It's all gone.
So I spent the last half hour just playing the skills games, and again, it really felt like the algorithm would give wins and losses in a manner that just kept me playing. I'd win with terrible scores, but then lose when I'd get some of my highest. So kind of sketchy, I don't know, but I ended up with $93 in the account. So coming out of this video, we didn't actually earn anything. The skills type games were fun, but given the algorithms in place there, I don't think that's a very reliable way to earn money. Axie Infinity, pretty risky, because who knows if that game will stay relevant, and it's pretty expensive to get in right now, but there is some opportunity there with the breeding and marketplace features. People do make money with that game. Playing poker, not the move. If you look at the stats, you basically have no chance of becoming a profitable player. Most people will lose money, or even worse, develop a gambling addiction. No way can I recommend that. But all that said, if someone put a glizzy to my dome and told me I had to make money using one of these methods or they shoot, I would probably go the crypto NFT type game route, or even just start streaming and making content playing games you actually enjoy. That would probably have the most upside potential with this kind of thing. But if you're in it strictly for the money, your time would be much better allocated doing freelance work online or just starting an online business. So this isn't something I would really recommend for the sole purpose of making money. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed this video and have an amazing rest of your day. Peace.